the Rockets once again keeping him together, and I do believe a very special guest on the desk.
Here he is, Tox, man. Congratulations. Thanks. And that handshake could have been better, could have been worse, though. So I think
I'll blame you for that.
Yeah, I think Zoots was still way worse at Denver. But congratulations. And that last frag that we saw in the highlight reel, 8 health against the Knicks, down to 1 final Rocket. You had so many situations like that in this match.
Yeah, I figure that with Zorlag, you got to gamble a bit. Like, you want to be really close. And sometimes my problem is that I might play a bit too defensive. So I wanted to be right at him and not let him have the chance of getting too much speed. So I was trying to play it as it were a practice game, basically.
Now, coming into this one, did you actually think it was going to go as close as it was into all 3 maps?
I thought I would maybe, if I would win a map, I would win DM6 with more ease. But he really hit some amazing rockets that always denied me entrance to fight for the heavy or the mega. And I couldn't find a way into DM6 at all. And Corrupted, I didn't feel that comfortable in the beginning. But I think he started to respect me a bit too much, because I was quite weak a few times. So I guess that's what's good for me. But I think I figured out how he likes to play, because he likes to double back a lot. So you need to predict that.
It looked like a lot of mutual respect, because there were times where, you know, you got away with like very little health. There was a moment on Corrupted, like you said, where he literally had 1 HP up on the LG. I'm not sure if you were aware, it was like literally 1, and you kind of backed off. So yeah, there was a lot of respect there, a lot of good shots. Ketchup, what were you thinking?
I mean, the main thing I really want to ask you is, obviously you've been playing a lot today, but I mean, Grand Finals in both game modes. Yeah. How does it feel that, obviously, Duel is only going to be half the work. There's still sacrifice, of course. You and the rest of the Stacked Boys had a ridiculous result against 2Z. How does it feel that, you know, the two biggest stages going into the end of this year, you're in both of them?
Yeah, I think I did a lot better in Duel than expected. My goal was to reach the top 8, because top 8 with this kind of competition would I consider a really good placement.
Oh, for sure.
Then I kind of got surprised when I managed to beat Noctis. And I guess after that game, I really got inspired to try to really go all the way, because I think that gave me a bit more confidence that my game was working and I didn't have to adapt more than I already have done. But the game against 2C was so intense, like, it could have gone either way.
I mean, you were a star performer in that as well. Like, you were just on fire in that final round. It was literally like nonstop, pretty much never missing that quad run, of course. Like, really feels like, you know, you're in your flow here, so anything's gonna be possible in Grand Finals for sure. How are you feeling about fighting Dehang?
I haven't played Dehang that much. I've been playing him in one Grand Final during Quake 4, and I played him at QuakeCon in Quake Live once. So I don't have that much experience against Dehang, but he's overall solid with all the weapons, and I have his timing down to point. I think I need to find a way how to manage his clutch, because it was a long time since I played against clutch. Since last couple of months, no one has really been using him in Duel. So I don't know how that would work out, but I'm going to try to play it quite different than the rest of the guys.
One of the things I've been commenting on during your performance, both in Sacrifice and through Duel, is your mechanics seem to be really on point. You know, your mouse control just seems to be really there for you in these games. Seems like your preparation was really good. Can you talk a little bit about your practice? And also, because you're a veteran Quake player, you played multiple versions of Quake. You know, it's not easy to transition to a new version of Quake, so you have to kind of adjust your play style to fit the new mold. Can you talk a little bit about the preparation that you've gone through, and maybe mentally, you know, we can all be a little egotistical as top duelers, thinking we're the best right away. You know, you have to check that. Can you talk a little bit about that and how you prepare?
Yeah, basically, up until I would say to Denver, I was just playing the game like everyone else. Like, after Denver, I really thought, like, how could I improve myself? And I know that my rocket launcher has always been one of the weakest weapon for me. And since the game is so much rocket and rail heavy right now, I figure, like, I kind of needed to get better at Rocket. And I know the reason behind why I've always struggled with Rocket is that I have, in the past, used quite low sensitivity. Mm-hmm. So I have increased my sensitivity to be able to keep up with the insane movement speed with Slash and Anarchy, and you know, it's constant fighting and sacrifice, and you need to do turns. And I have never really played with acceleration, so I guess I play a lot of free-for-all, not to win the free-for-all. I'm playing free-for-all to just try things. Like, yes. I can tell myself, like, this game I'm only going to use rocket launcher, or now I'm going to use shotgun. So I always try to figure out a way how I can improve and feel confident about my weapons. If I know that I'm going to hit, then I can play out.
Yeah.
As soon as I don't hit, I need to fall back to the basic, like running the items and how to play defensive. But when you're on fire, like in the field that you're hitting a lot, then you can really take advantage of your knowledge, which you have gathering during all this year of all different kind of Quake games.
That's a great point too about sensitivity. That's another question I could kind of go at that again. Is you said you added Excel. Talk about you can get too, as you know, you can get too high of a sensitivity, but you also mentioned too low. There's like this happy medium you're gonna have to find. So this is the first time you've been using Excel, is that what
I have been using a slight Excel this tournament. Some of the games I have used it and some I haven't. It depends on kind of how I feel during that day and how tense I are with my movement, with my arm. So this last game I was using my original without acceleration. But in the beginning, I have been using Excel during the event.
Interesting. You're making adjustments on the fly. Impressive.
Yeah. You have to.
I think that's the sound of a couple thousand people running off to change their configs now. Yeah. So you managed to slide into the grand final and up against a Hang. Good luck. And of course, you know, we have the Sacrifice final coming up as well. Everybody's got their workout cut out for them, and yourself included. So best of luck to you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
As we go into it here, let's take one more look at this bracket.